What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another HTV video, and as you guys can see in front of you today, man, a card you might not have expected me to do a gameplay on because I've never been a big fan of him, but 2K has made some adjustments on this card, and he went from being one of the most unusable centers to potentially the best center in the game. I'm talking about 99 overall, Dark Matter maxed out, Patrick Ewing, who's got the 99 post, 99 mid-range. But honestly, we're here to talk about one big thing, and that's the fact that 2K has changed this man's jumper. Now, you guys will see it later on as we look at the stats and stuff, but it is crazy how changing one little thing can affect a card so much. A big example of this is the Dark Matter Dikembe Mutombo that we got last year. Up until last year, Dikembe Mutombo wasn't really a usable card because he always had that catapult jumper. Last year, they gave him a godlike jumper, and he was the best center in the game. That might be the case with this Patrick Ewing. Now, as always, if you guys are new to the channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button. We're on that grind to 300k. Y'all have been showing insane love. We're just about to hit 295, so thank you so much for that. And let's also aim for 2,000 likes on today's video. But with that being said, man, with all the centers currently out, is Patrick Ewing gonna be that guy? Let's take a look. So we got the 99 offense, 99 defense, standing at 7 feet tall, 240 pounds, and when you look at the stats, man, they've given him the love. 86 driving layup, post game goes absolutely nuts, 99 mid-range, 85 three ball, 85 mid-range, 90 standing and driving dunk. He can almost speed boost, three away from that. Decent passing, defense goes absolutely nuts, 95 block, 97 interior, 84 perimeter, and 88 steal. Phenomenal rebounding, 90 speed and acceleration with an 87 speed with ball. He's got the vertical, he's got the strength, 89 lateral quickness. Mental game looks good. I mean, on paper, Patrick Ewing every year always looks good. It always just comes down to the animations, which seems to be fixed in 2K this year. 95 pass, 85 on ball, 97 shot contest and block. I mean, it's looking like there's nothing wrong with this card. And then we get to the badges, and this is where things get crazy. 24 Hall of Famers, 26 gold, and in the background, you guys will get to see his brand new, insanely fast and glitchy jumper that they've given to Ewing. They changed the base, and now it's an absolute problem, but he's got Hall of Fame catch and shoot, Hall of Fame corner specialist, difficult shots, brick wall, post spin technician, drop stepper, rim protector, and as we go down, you'll see he basically has every defensive badge in the game. Box, clamps, interceptor, intimidator, hook specialist, rebound chaser, pogo stick, post lockdown, tireless defender, worm, back down punisher, fade ace, downhill, dream shake, set shooter, the Hall of Fame sniper to help that jumper even more, and post playmaker. I mean, those are the perfect badges for a big man. All that's really missing is limitless spot up to go crazy with this card, but man, this is nuts. Gold fearless finisher, acrobat, you got the lob city, glue hands, pickpocket, pick dodger, the posterizer, pro touch, which really doesn't work this year, but a needle threader, gold quick first step, green machine, hot zone hunter for the corners there, you got the bullet passer as well. There's not really too much that this card is missing for a big man. You can give him dimer, but dimer's not really like that this year. Maybe lucky number 7, maybe the blinders. I recommend the limitless spot up just to feel a bit more confident from that 3-point line. But aside from that, man, this Ewing has been blessed. I'd probably give him that Deadeye as well and unstrippable. I'm surprised he does not have that as a big man. And on top of that, the mouse in the house. But aside from that, Ewing looks great on paper. And I can't wait to see what a brand new Patrick Ewing is going to be able to do. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's hop into a game and let's see if Patrick Ewing is really that guy. Let's get into it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another HTB gameplay. Patrick Ewing, Luka Doncic, a little finesse on the snatchback. Easy three right there for Luka. Not gonna work out, and apparently it does. You really don't need to time anything in the game this year. They made shooting way too easy. Catch, pump fake, he's jumping at that, stopping, he's behind me. First three of the night for Patrick Ewing, and it's going down. I still can't believe they've given him that jumper. It just makes no sense, but I'm here for it. I'm just glad he finally got blessed, because all these other centers were getting new jumpers. Like Bill Russell's jumper, he had Exum last year, made no sense. Good defense there by the big man. Let's keep it going. That's a free rebound. Come on, Ewing. Let's get things done. The man's hitting that square button like crazy. Slow down. Look at how the game is moving. Everyone is just so skippy. Luka's open for three, a little too easy there, and we're knocking that down. As long as we don't let Luka shoot the ball, we're in good hands. Good contest there. Thank you for jumping at that, Ewing. That's the kind of hustle I want to see on this team. Let me go right back into that pick and fade. I'm trying to show off that three-pointer as much as possible. Doesn't work out there. Get me in the post. He's got a glitchy fadeaway too. Don't get it twisted. Look at that. Easy greens, baby. Y'all know how we get down. If I get him to hit that screen, slip that screen right away. Thank you. If I see him trying to go over the screen, we're trying to slip that as soon as possible. Beautiful slip there. No matter what, do not let Luka shoot the ball. Anybody else can do anything. Good defense there by David Robinson. Let him hit the square button as much as he needs. Ewing, I got you. Dimer me, mama. Bang! Look at Ewing, man. Now jumping into the second quarter. I'm liking what I'm seeing so far from Ewing. Look at him just sitting on that car. Look at that easy blow by. Luka's got the easy dunk. Could have thrown that missile to Rudy Gay as well. And I think I thought Luka got injured there for a second. Give me that. Good defense there. Come on. We hustled for that. Oh my goodness, bro. Defense. Yo, working so hard on defense and for what? Let's go all the way through. I know you're just looking at Patrick Ewing. So I'm going to keep attacking with Luka for now. Get in the post. Get in the post. Out to Luka. That's an easy dime. Look at Patrick Ewing and Luka doing magical things together right now, man. You love to see it. You got to fix up those defensive settings. All the way. Out to Ewing. One more swing. Kobe beat Bryant. That's another amazing three. And our team is making plays out of the post right now. Switch on that screen. Switch on that screen. Good defense. Throw it inside. I thought he would throw it. What a step back three. Definitely hasn't been the ideal second quarter here. Luka catches it from the wrong spot. Swing it to Kobe. Beautiful catch and shoot. That's another three right there. He's got his eyes on Ewing now, so I gotta move the ball around. Get there, get there, get there. Good defense. Good defense there by Luka. Come on, we run. Let's go to Giannis first, then to Ewing. That's an easy dunk in transition. See, now we're starting to get things going. Come on, it's all about the stops. Come hit that screen. Yes, sir, hit that. Throw it right to Giannis. Giannis, easy layup right there. We got it to go. He's sitting in the corner. I'm watching for it. He's definitely got his defense stepped up in the second quarter, trying to get the off-ball deodorant going. He tries to reach for it. There we go. One more swing. My boy in the corner waiting for that three ball, and he's going to knock it down. Good defense. Good defense. Good defense. Get there. Get there. Good defense. Hands up. Hands up. That was good defense. Oh, 2K just stays blessing this man today, but that's all good, man. Luka, I know you're my automatic bucket. Hit that screen. Stop and thank you. He's on my side. That's a green. Thank you, Luka Magic. Now in the second half, you're going to see what we can get into. Throw that dot to Giannis. Thank you. Easy three. Give me all three of those, Giannis. He wants to sit in the corner. We're going to be hawking it. Easy pick and roll right there. Yes, sir. Hit that screen. All the way to the basket. Stopping. Easy mash right there. Thank you, Luka. Let him sit on Kevin Garnett. Honestly, I don't mind the off ball. It's working out right now. Easy crossover. All the way through. Luka in the corner. Automatic three. That's another green right there. Keep sitting on that power forward. It's a Patrick Ewing gameplay, but I'm looking to walk out of here with a win. We know what Ewing can do. Jump at that. Oh, I got to jump earlier. Luka is so deadly. Good defense there. Beautiful. Where are we going here? Let's go all the way with Luka. Right to the corner. Beautiful three in transition. And my Arthur Sharpshooter is knocking it down. Our team is on it right now. I just need a couple more stops. We got him on the post. In the post, in the post. This should be an easy bucket. I'm trying to pump fake. Pump fake. He's in the air. That's an easy bucket. He's so tired, so I didn't want to try anything crazy. He can still get stripped. Switch on that. Switch on that. Good switch. Good switch. Good switch. He's got to throw it out. I try to get the stop there. That's on me. Giannis trying to get the block. Yo, this man got ourselves a 4-point game right here. If I see that KG drop, you know I'm throwing that missile to the corner. Thank you. Easy greens once again. And that's going down. Maybe I should move Patrick Ewing to the four. He gets so many open corner threes. Easy bucket. Thank you. I was trying not to commentate there because I was a little bit worried. This is a very back and forth game. I need a decent lead going into the fourth quarter. Switch on that screen. Stay on him. Stay on him. There we go. I'd rather have him have the two every single time. We got to fight for those boards, and that's what we're doing. Let's go right to Cade. Now slow things down. Slow things down. Make him hit that screen. Yes, sir. Going all the way with Cunningham. Hey! Beautiful dunk. That's what you love to see, man. Need a nice little pick and roll right here. Hit that screen. Thank you. Stopping. And he's going to give me the space. That's an easy mid-range. That's an easy bucket. Patrick Ewing just got injured. Oh, my goodness. Of course, man. We got to get this man off the court. Okay, so it looks like Coach took Patrick Ewing out anyways. Honestly, guys, even though he didn't have a ton of points, the card was great, especially defensively. Look at that. He keeps trying to bait the corner. What are you doing? Get there. Good defense there by the Admiral. Get the ball. You're an absolute dog. All the way through. Little spin move. Pump fake. He's in the air. That should be an easy layup. And it is 69-55. Come on, man. Throw it here. Good defense there by Embiid. Way to get the loose ball there, Luka. We basically just vibing at this point, guys. Luka, you want to get a three? There we go. Snatch back. Thank you. In your face. Beautiful green. Not even contested. And that's going down. Look at Luka's always showing up in every gameplay. All right. So GG's to my opponent. We're going to go ahead and win this game 74-59. Ewing did his thing. The rest of the team was hooping when he went down. Let's go ahead. Let's check out the box score and let's see our boy did. All right, so as you guys can see, man, Patrick Ewing, in the 17 minutes that he played, he had 18 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals, and 1 block. All around, very efficient stat line. Obviously, Luka was going crazy as well, but I've told you guys every single video, Luka is just that card. But 8 for 16 from the field, 2 for 5 from 3. We were definitely forcing shots towards the end when he was exhausted, but y'all saw the jumper. Y'all saw what he can do in the post. The card's legit, in my opinion. No free throws this game. Walked away with a couple dunks and a pinch. Right elbow nerve is going to be the injury. All around, I gotta say, guys, it is really nice to have a Patrick Ewing that's not just usable in the game, because in previous years, he was somewhat usable. Not only is this card usable, but he's actually a top tier center in the game, in my opinion. And the crazy thing about this card is, with the stats that he has, the speed, the athleticism, the size, just like David Robinson, he is gonna be a problem at that power forward position. The man is nuts. He can rebound. He can match up against other bigs. So if you're someone that's wanting to run a solid 2 big man lineup, for example, D-Rob and Hakeem, D-Rob and Ewing, Patrick Ewing and Shaq, you can now do it comfortably knowing at that power forward spot, Patrick Ewing actually got things locked down. It's actually quite scary that you can play him at the 4 or the 5, and he's gonna be one of the better cards at that position. Obviously, again, we're forcing shots. He got injured. This man was mainly making sure I could not score with his card, but it didn't matter in the end. He got what he wanted. He walked away with a solid stat line, and in my opinion, for the price that I picked him up for, I mean, compared to a lot of the other centers in the game, I honestly think he's going to be worth it. Obviously, that jumper, even though it is much faster now, is still going to take some getting used to, because just because the jumper's a lot faster doesn't mean you yourself are going to be greening more shots. Practice with the shot a little bit off the pick and pop, off the catch. Off the catch in the corner, there is no chance you should be missing with this card, because it's basically like Luka's. It is automatically green, but yeah, man, in my opinion, if this is a card you end up picking up, if you're a Knicks fan that's been waiting for a good Patrick Ewing card, he is finally here. Now, would I take him over a David Robinson? I'm not too sure quite yet, because even though all around I feel like he moves and he feels bigger than D-Rob, D-Rob's jumper is still one of the best in the game, if not the best right now on a big man. But running Ewing and D-Rob at the same time, now that's a deadly combo. I'm gonna have to play around with this card a little bit to decide if he's really that much better than Hakeem, because Hakeem does feel, you know, a bit more present on defense, but with this card's faster jumper on offense, he offers more than Hakeem would in the post and the three-point line. But that's gonna do it for today's video, guys. If you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like. And for you new viewers, you know you gotta hit that subscribe button and join the Blazion Nation. I wanna thank you guys for watching. I hope you all have an awesome day, and take care.